there are different themes in this film. One of them is masculinity or being a man. I'm younger than the main character, but I have an old-fashioned upbringing, and there was old-fashioned upbringing, so I identify myself with the children and the grandchildren, and actually the main character as well. I'm supposed to be the opposite. I'm supposed to be the modern man that is intact with my heart and my emotions, but my past is, I'm raised by a similar guy. So, I'm maybe defining myself at the same time, and I think, a topic like this is not only relevant for people at their age, the main character says it's relevant for all of us, because there is a Hannes in every family, if it's a grandfather or a great-grandfather or a father or even a husband.
In its surface, maybe the film is very Icelandic. It's made in Iceland. The title refers to something that's maybe specific for Iceland. But would you say it's an Icelandic story as well?
Yeah, definitely, yes, and then at the other hand, maybe not. I think I'm not saying this is a good story, but all good films or good stories have an international appeal to it, and the identity of where the film takes place comes with the nuances. I think the same story could actually take place here in the Netherlands, but of course there would be some other different thing that would be his background, and some other elements that of the local identity. But more or less, love stories are international, and to develop as a person or take a decision to do that, that's international as well. So. But of course, the Numa, it takes place in Iceland, and there are some extreme Icelandic things, of course, in it. But I hope that that it has an international approach to it. I would like to just say that this was maybe I'm naive, maybe or something like that. This wasn't supposed to be an act that people would start to throw things at each other in the audience, but that has happened. For me, it's quite often asked, what is your opinion of euthanasia, or mercy killing, or killing, or however people look at it? And in this story, this was supposed to be an act of love. He was able to do something for her that he wasn't able to do for himself. And the naive part of me that I'm referring to earlier is that I never expected this to be the big debate that it has become in some places where the film has been shown. In France, people are literally taking their shoes off and throwing it at each other, and a Catholic priest come over to me and spit at my face, and then I have a Catholic priest coming over to me and saying, okay, I really thought I had a clear view of this topic, but I'm not saying that you have changed my view, but I'm thinking now, can I get your email? I will maybe write to you. And he has never written to me, but... this, of course, is an extreme thing that happens, this act. But it was never supposed to be a political statement. It's not a propaganda for euthanasia, not the government. But I guess my stand, I wrote the manuscript and I love all my characters. So I guess, at least in the exact circumstances that were portrayed in this film, that then I'm accepting that. But that doesn't mean, and it's such a difficult subject as well to put this in law, because in each and every case it's so hard to generalize about this topic. To have some dry written text when you're allowed to take somebody's life and not, I think it's impossible, actually. And it's impossible that people will agree on it. But in general, it's Second World War memoirs that he's reading, and so some people have got quite shocked seeing a swastika on one of the books that he's reading. It's not supposed to be. He's not supposed to be a Nazi. He's just guys that reads about sea and Second World memoirs. And yeah, the book that he's reading is Second World War memoirs. But I thought it was such a nice text actually. And as well, we were playing with the element of water and ships throughout the set design, and so we have another scene that was not in the film, that he's reading a love story. Like, all the literature is finished, so he grabs a book of hers, so he's starting to talk about some doctor that is with a fair hair and the nurse that is quite a funny scene, but it's going to be on the DVD in the extra material, I guess. Yeah, in 1973, there was these eruptions in a small island, and everybody were evacuated from those islands within a couple of hours. And those eruptions were ongoing for 6 months. So when people slowly started to return back, they have to dig up the houses that didn't go under lava. They went under tempera, that is like sand, ash. So they had to dig up the town, and it was 2/3 that came back. And so his backstory is, he didn't come back. And that's quite undertold in the story. But the material in the opening credit is from that eruptions. And then, it's referred to within two dialogue scenes, basically, but in a really low-key manner, actually. Like many other things in the film, it's quite undertold. But I'm always hoping when I'm under-telling things that people get a sense of it, at least. So I hope that it came through for some of you. And one of many things, his upbringing that we don't see in flashbacks, but just this stereotypical old-fashioned guy that, and if they have problems, they don't seek help, or they don't, so it piles up. So he had been drifting away from himself and be like a fish on a dry land ever since, but being so proud at the same time that he wouldn't admit to it. Yeah, maybe the son is a little bit like me at some stage in my life, that he thinks that he's that better than the father, and he thinks, but he doesn't see the father in himself. So he thinks that he's actually better than he actually is. He thinks he's the modern man, but he hasn't evolved that much, actually.
Maybe he's a gay guy, or not?
Yeah, that's another movie. I would love to have the opportunity of working with all those actors again, so maybe we do a sequel. But thank you guys really much.